Will be traveling north of the border to take on the Raptors in game one on Thursday. Kevin Durant's status has been up in the air as he still nurses that calf injury. But with the Warriors cruising to five straight victories without KD, some are wondering if Golden State even needs the services of the back-to-back finals MVP. Here's Durant on all the noise surrounding his status.
It's hard to get away from that, you know, because I watch the games and you watch the lead up into the games, and that's all everybody's talking about. And my perspective is just like, I want to focus on rehab, but I also want to be a fan of my teammates, you know what I'm saying? I want to enjoy, you know, my teammates from a different view, you know what I'm saying? And a lot of those guys sit in a chair, I get opportunity to do the same thing. And I turn on TV, since I can't travel with the team, all you hear is the noise, you know what I'm saying? So as a player, I think about that and I'm just like, that's just not true. You know, that's not facts when it comes to that from a basketball perspective. And, you know, but the competitive side of me, I also like to talk basketball as well. So if you're going to say something like that, I'm going to engage in it. So it's all fun. It's all cool. But I know the real. It's been that way since I got here, is the Warriors and KD, you know what I'm saying? And I understand that. And I felt like my teammates and the organization know exactly what I've done here on and off the court to become a part of this culture, to kind of, you know, kind of stamp my flag in this, you know, in this coach and this organization. I've done in, you know, last 2 years, pretty much everything that they asked me to do, from player, from an ambassador, I guess, of the organization and the community, from, you know, working hard every single day in shoot arounds and practice. So I know what I bring to the team, but I also know that a lot of people on the outside, you know, don't like to see us together. And, you know, I get it.
I like that answer. I liked that whole riff. I liked everything you had to say. It felt honest. It felt like, here's where it's at. This is where the table's set. And now let's just kind of move forward and see what happens. But how badly, Nick, do the Warriors need KD against this Raptors team?
Well, I mean, we don't know if he's going to play, and they're enormous favorites in Vegas. When we do our picks.
Without him.
Well, I mean, that's the Vegas, right. You can make a bet on him now. We don't know if he's going to play. We don't expect him to play, at the very least, game one. Toronto has home court. And the Warriors are still something like minus 285 favorites in the series. Are the Warriors better without Kevin Durant? That's a question that is an interesting one, but the answer almost has to be no, even though they went at a higher percentage without him. Just logically, it can't be true that they would be better without a player of his caliber. But do they need Kevin Durant? That's not that complicated of a question, and the answer's always been no. They would like to have him, but they don't need him. Can they win this series without him? Absolutely. If he were ruled out today for the rest of the year, do you think there'd be a whole bunch of pundits, not the pundits know everything or anything, picking the Raptors to win the championship? I don't. There'd be slightly more than are going to pick them this week as is. So I understand Kevin Durant's frustration, but when one of the reasons his decision got pilloried differently than other free agent decisions was because the thought process was, they don't need you. And then even if he tried to debunk that through his amazing play through 2+ years and then the first half of these NBA playoffs, what the Warriors have done, most notably what Steph Curry has done since he's gone down, has just reinforced the idea of you are a luxury and not a necessity. So I understand where KD would be frustrated. Are the Warriors better without me? Of course they're not better without. I understand that part of it. But the tougher question is, do they need me? And I believe the answer to that question is unequivocally no.
I don't think they're better without KD. All right. It's just from a logical standpoint, being in too many locker rooms with great players, being in too many locker rooms with marginal players. When you realize you look across the court, across the field, and you're like, man, they're better than us. They got more stars than us. They got more firepower than we do. So we have less margin of error. Because, Nick, last week, all I heard, the last 2 weeks, all I've heard is Golden State, what their record is without Kevin Durant. All right. Everyone goes back and forth. Oh, they've won this. They've done this. That's a page for a record-breaking season. Let me tell you what they haven't done with Kevin Durant. They didn't lose a 3-1 championship lead. They didn't do that. So Steph Curry, you can tell me all those numbers. Oh, Steph Curry, when he's in the lineup. Steph Curry was on the court when they were up 3-1 to OKC. So Kevin Durant, you can say, no, the numbers don't say that. But with playoff
when they were up 3-1 to Cleveland.
To Cleveland, yes. But that's the difference to me. Is someone like Kawhi. The reason why they went out and caught KD was for LeBron. Now they're facing a team that's in the top five defensively, top five offensively. There are only two teams this year, Toronto Raptors and the Milwaukee Bucks. So in a series where you can clutch, you can grab in the playoffs, you need a Kevin Durant. You need to be able to offset. What about Kevin Durant guarding Kawhi for 20 minutes? Kawhi would have a problem with his length. So he would have to try to take him inside. He wouldn't be able to shoot over him. So Kevin Durant would be a problem for Kawhi. What about taking some of that energy with Kawhi? You know he's a little bit gimpy. And if he's got to guard KD, if he's got to guard KD 20 to 30 minutes, that's going to take something out of him. So in playoffs, in a series like this, yes, I would prefer to have Kevin Durant because they have someone like Kawhi. If I was going through the regular season, you don't need him. But the one thing they haven't done with KD, they didn't lose a championship. Well, they did lose one with the rest of them.
That's absolutely true. And it was, obviously, the sequence of events was KD without these guys blew a 3-1 lead of his own. Then these guys without KD blew a 3-1 lead of their own. And then together since then, they haven't lost a playoff series. They've only faced elimination one game, that game seven, or two games, game six and seven against the Rockets in the Western Conference Finals last year. But and the numbers are that Chris is talking about is when Steph plays and KD doesn't, they're 34-4. And when KD plays and Steph doesn't, they're 28-8. That's the difference between a team being on a 50-win pace and a 73-win pace. And so that their record with Steph and without KD is better than their record with them both. But the reason that I don't think anyone can make a case they're better without him, even if those numbers are, that's a big sample size, and even if, like I said, their defense is better and Steph is better and Draymond's better, all those things, is right now this moment, Kevin Durant's going to be a free agent this offseason. If you root against the Warriors and you're trying to say they're better off without Kevin Durant or with Kevin, they are worse with Kevin Durant, then in theory you're rooting for him to stay. And nobody that roots against the Warriors is rooting for him to stay because everyone knows they are more dangerous with him. But they don't need him. And everyone wants to feel needed. And for Kevin Durant, and this injury came at almost a cruel time because he was playing at a level where it seemed like they had to have him. He's averaging 39-5-5. And then immediately he goes down and Steph inserts himself in that area of production. 36-8-7. So it's very hard to make the case, given what we've seen over these 5 years, that they have to have Kevin Durant, even against Kawhi Leonard.
But if they didn't need him in the Blazers series, you can make a case that they probably do need him against this Toronto team, especially with Kawhi playing the way we just saw him play.
Toronto is such a better defensive team than the teams they faced in the West. They're so much better. Look at all the minutes during the Portland series. Golden State was down. Golden State, yeah, they did win these games because they have veteran experience. What Milwaukee didn't, so they were able to come back. But if you look at the number of minutes, Portland had the lead. They didn't have a closer, and they didn't have their superstars show up. And they are not a good defensive team. So, I mean, this to me, it's quite simple.
And I think it can boil down to this. Kevin Durant drastically raises the Warriors' floor. He drastically raises what a bad Warriors game is. But it doesn't appear to me he raises their ceiling much at all. The best Warriors game without him and the best Warriors game with him is about the same thing.
Would they have won the Clippers series without KD?
Absolutely. Absolutely they would have won the Clippers series without Kevin Durant. 100%.
Wow.
I believe they would. I mean, we saw that in the Portland series. They would have played.
No. I thought the Clippers were a better matchup than Portland.
Oh, okay. So what I think happened in the Clippers series was one of the reasons that he can do what he did in those final four games and they still lose one of them is everyone else has to take a step back. They just play a different style of basketball without him. And so they're not better without him. But he knows it and the whole basketball world knows it. They don't need him. And they don't necessarily even need him to win a championship this year.
All right, let's take a break. Coming up, speaking of Kawhi, is he the best player in the NBA Finals now? Next on First Things First.
Your hair and makeup people getting ready to come onto the set.